every pony. How did the trial go?
Oh, hey, Spike. Well, we won.
That's great news! So, Scootaloo and Turning Page are off the hook?
Yeah, they are.
So, why the long face?
Where do I even begin?
Oh, Spikey Wikey, it's awful, I tell you.
Huh? Rarity? What happened?
The gods! They've arrested Smitty, though!
Wait, what? You're not saying...
Yeah, Scootaloo and Turning were proven innocent. But the evidence now implicates Sweetie Belle and another pony named Sugar Stamp instead.
Huh? Miss Stamp and Sweetie Belle? Are you serious?
We are, Spike. It was horrible. We couldn't do a single thing except watch him drag her away.
Serves her right for not believing in Scootaloo.
I beg your pardon.
Yeah, Rainbow, what do you mean by that?
I mean exactly what I said! Sweetie Belle suspected Scootaloo the entire time! And not only that, she kept quiet about everything that happened that night!
Rainbow Dash, in case you've forgotten, Sweetie Belle herself said she didn't suspect Scootaloo! She just didn't want to risk interfering with the investigation!
And you buy that? Why else would she be acting so shady?
Perhaps she was scared! Because a certain Pegasus kept harassing her from the very beginning!
Well, maybe if she wasn't so obviously lying, I wouldn't have to confront her about it! And look where it got her! Arrested for murder!
Are you suggesting that she's somehow actually responsible?
It would explain a whole lot, wouldn't it?
Girls, enough! This ain't getting us anywhere! We need to-
How dare you insinuate my little sister would- kill any pony! She's just a child!
Doesn't matter who you are! When you get arrested for murder, every pony thinks you did it! No matter what!
And because of that, this justifies presuming she's guilty?
Rarity, please. You gotta calm down.
Calm down? Calm down? Applejack, don't you dare tell me to calm down! Not when our supposed friend here has the audacity to say that my little sister is a it was Applebloom whom she was accusing. You'd feel the same way. Don't tell me you wouldn't. Don't tell me you don't care in the slightest.
That's not... Land sakes, Rarity, I do care, but...
But she knows as well as any pony else that Sweetie Belle is lying.
Now don't you go putting words in my mouth, Rainbow Dash. All I'm saying is...
Oh, Rainbow Dash, I am truly appalled. Out of all of us, I would have thought you'd understand the most!
Understand what?
What it feels like to be suspected of a crime you didn't commit! To have no pony believe in you! To have every pony turn their backs and not give the matter a second thought! Weren't you suspected of murder once?
Rarity! That's more than enough!
That's totally different!
Is it? Is it really, Rainbow Dash? Or are you just saying that because it helps you avoid having a guilty conscience? Stop it!
Applebloom?
None of this matters, okay? It don't matter if Sweetie Belle did or didn't suspect Scootaloo. What matters is figuring out how we're gonna get her out of this mess. Rainbow Dash, I get it. I'm hurt by what Sweetie Belle did. And I'm mad that she didn't want to help out with Scootaloo. I get it! But I also know that Sweetie Belle is innocent. She's as innocent as you, me, Scoots, and Turnin' Page. She didn't do anything wrong. So that means we gotta prove that, no matter how we feel about it. Because we can't just abandon her, like how others abandoned you, Rainbow, or how they abandoned Scootaloo. And Rarity! I know you're mighty upset, too. I sure would be if Applejack was hauled off. But blaming Rainbow ain't gonna help Sweetie Belle neither. Pointing hooves and trying to say who's to blame isn't gonna get us anywhere. All it's gonna do is make us even more upset and put Sweetie Belle in even more danger.
Applebloom.
And I'm scared, too. I'm scared. I'm angry. I'm upset. But I gotta be better than that. I gotta get past myself and do something about this. And we all gotta be better than that, too. For her sake!
Apple Bloom's right. I know every pony is upset. But we need to focus on the case at hoof. Arguing like this is going to get us nowhere.
Agreed. If there's anyone to blame for her arrest, it's me. I suggested that the blood behind the statue belonged to the true killer, after all. I just never expected the blood to be from Sweetie Belle.
You shouldn't put the blame on yourself, Athena. I took part in this as well.
Neither of you did anything wrong. All you did was point out what the evidence said. It just so happens that one of our friends got caught in the crossfire.
So, what should we do then?
Do you even need to ask? You already know the answer to that, don't you?
You're right. I do. Hey, Rarity?
Huh? Yes, Athena?
I took on Scootaloo and Turning's case, and I was able to save them. It only makes sense that I should do the same thing for your sister.
So you're saying?
If it's all right with you, I'd like to defend Sweetie Belle.
None of us want to see a friend accused of a crime they didn't commit. So I promise, we'll also make sure that Sweetie Belle gets the acquittal she deserves.
Exactly. With Twilight by my side.
And Athena by mine. We will prove her innocence together.
Yes! Thank you! Thank you! Thank you! Please bring my sister back to me!
We won't let you down, Rarity.
Whatever.
Actually, Twilight? I'm sorry, but I'm still a little confused about this case. I mean, what do we even know for sure?
Well, we know that clones were involved.
Clones? Are you serious?
Yeah, but that's absolutely crazy. Does that mean we have two victims we're dealing with?
I was wondering the same thing. Two royal orders.
You're right. This is crazy. It's still hard to believe, even if all the evidence points to it being true.
Maybe it'll help if we go over Royal Order's movements that night? Everything that we know, and need to know, center around figuring out what he did and where he did them.
That's a good idea, Twilight. But where would we start?
How about when he first got home? We know that that was when he learned what Turning Page was doing from Fair Devotion.
Right. And afterwards, he teleported to Froggy Bottom Bog. We know that because it's currently the only place where potent enough Poison Joe can be found.
But why would he teleport to Froggy Bottom Bog in the first place?
Maybe it was because he thought Turning might be there. It was somewhere the two visited often. When he couldn't find his son at the bog, he then visited the mirror pool. But how could he have known where it was?
On top of that, why would the mirror pool be his next instinct? Why not immediately try to head off to find Turning Page somewhere else?
Honestly, I don't know why either. Even if our mirror pool theory explains why Royal was away, it doesn't explain how he knew about it.
Regardless, he made a clone, and the two of them split up, perhaps to cover more ground. One of them headed to the clearing, and the other to the statue.
And we know what happened on the way there.
You mean when Scootaloo crashed into something on the crossroads? Because she was distracted by the timber wolves?
Oh, right. Those things.
Exactly. We managed to establish that that was one of the Royal Order clones. The crash resulted in the scooter breaking and the left handlebar stabbing Royal Order's head.
It must have been too much for Scootaloo at that point. And that's why she fled.
Thinking you'd stab someone? It'd be too much for anyone, let alone a little kid.
Does that mean Scootaloo killed that Royal Order?
No, that stab wound must not have been fatal since, based on the blood trail, that Royal Order managed to stand and head over to the Nightmare Knight statue. That was where he was killed, impaled on the statue's base somehow. The Timberwolves in the area then ate the body and lapped up all the blood afterwards.
Well, not quite all of it. There was blood behind the statue which belonged to Sweetie Belle, mixed with royal orders in front of the statue.
And that's why she's been arrested.
Oh, Sweetie Belle, what in Equestria were you doing there?
Well, wait, what about the other royal order? The one that went to the clearing?
Well, we determined that it was at the clearing where that royal order died, not at the castle. But because his body was found at the castle by Zecora, Diamond Tiara, and Silver Spoon, along with the wagon, silk, capes, and scooter, the police arrested Scootaloo for murder.
But that doesn't make any sense. Scootaloo left those things at the crossroads after she crashed. How did they make it back to the scene?
Yeah, and how the body get there as well?
That's where we believe Sugar Stamp was involved. The imprint on the bottom of the wagon matches the badge on her mail bag. We think she transported the items from the crossroads.
And the body that died at the clearing by flying all of them over the forest to the castle.
But why would she do that? Because she's the killer?
We can't say that for certain just yet. Regardless, that should be everything we know so far.
Wow. This case is so complex. How can you keep track of everything that's happened?
I think I'll leave that to Widget, rather than give myself a headache.
We're still left in the dark about a lot of things, sadly.
So, where do we go from here?
What we should do first is go to Sweetie Belle. She's probably at the detention center by now.
Scootaloo and Turning Page might be there, too, so we should talk to them as well. Maybe we could even speak to Zecora if she's there.
We'll also need to talk to Diamond and Silver. Since they were behind the blackmailing, they might know something that could help us out. Although, I'm not sure if they'd be willing to cooperate, considering what we put them through today.
We'll cross that bridge when we get to it. What else?
There's also the Everfree Forest. Now that we know that the clearing and crossroads were involved, we'll need to investigate them thoroughly.
Looks like we got our game plan. Let's first head out to the detention center. Boss, you coming with us?
Of course!
I should come too! Sweetie Belle needs me!
I figured you would. And Rainbow? Ooh, yeah. She still doesn't look happy. As much as I don't think it'd be a good idea for her and Rarity to be together, Rainbow needs to come too. You probably want to join us, right? To check up on Scootaloo?
Yeah, I'll come along.
Applejack, what about you?
I appreciate the offer, Twi, but there's still some work to do at the farm. And I reckon it's time I took Apple Bloom back, too, before some pony else causes trouble for us. Sorry, girls. I didn't mean to sound insensitive.
It's all right, Applejack. I understood what you meant.
I have a feeling it's going to be a while before those three patch things up.
Trouble? Me?
You know what I meant, Sugar Cube. Now come on, let's be off. Take care, y'all.
Yeah. Good luck, every pony!
In which case, we'd better get going.
Wait a second! I want to come too!
Huh? How come?
I'm just so bored just staying in the castle while you guys are going off all over Ponyville! I want to help!
Trucy, we're already bringing enough people as it is. I think you should just...
Please, Daddy! I really want to go!
All right. I can't say no to that face. Just behave yourself.
Yay!
I take it you're going to stay here again, Apollo.
Not a chance, Athena. I'm coming with you this time around, for my own sanity, if nothing else. And besides, you never know. Maybe having an extra lawyer on this case will yield us some helpful results.
Sounds good then. Even though being in this world clearly troubles you, you're still just as willing to lend a hand. I shouldn't have expected anything less. Thanks, Apollo.
Then on that note, I think that's everyone. It'll make for a somewhat crowded detention center, but that can't be helped.
Gotcha, boss. You ready, Twilight?
Just a sec. Spike, you don't mind?
I'll be right here when you need me, Twi. Don't you worry. Now go off and say Sweetie Belle!
We'll do our best, Spike. Okay, everyone, let's get going.
Hmm? Oh, it's you guys again.
Yeah? We're here to see Sweetie Belle. Is she here?
She's currently in questioning right now. You'll have to come back later.
Jeez, talk about a stick in the mud. This guy never lets up, does he?
What about Scootaloo and Turning Page? Are they still here?
Miss Fair Devotion stopped by a moment ago to pick them up, Your Highness.
Pick up? You mean Scoots is at Turning and Fair's house right now?
I don't know where else she'd be.
That's all I needed to hear. Wait, Rainbow!
Let her go, Twilight. I kind of expected that to happen.
Fine. I have some more questions to ask anyway.
Such as?
Can you tell us what happened to Diamond Tiara and Silver Spoon?
They were questioned for a little while, then they were later released with no charges filed against them. Their parents came and picked them up not too long ago.
No charges, huh? No prizes for guessing why that is.
I guess that means we better go talk to them later, then.
There's another thing I'd like to know. Where's the Korra?
She left soon after the trial was over, and was seen heading back to the Everfree Forest.
Straight back home, I suppose.
After what you put her through? That zebra deserves a lot more than rest, that's for sure.
I'm well aware of that.
Anything else?
Just one more thing, actually. Is Private Eye still in Canterlot?
Correct. He and his team are currently tracking down Miss Sugarstamp.
And when will he be back?
Whenever they find her, I should think.
Gee, thanks. At this point, I don't know why I expected anything from this guy.
In any case, Miss Sweetie Belle will not be released from questioning for some time. If you have any further questions, ask them now. Otherwise, I have to get back to my shift. I already have a long enough day as is.
Right. No, I think that's everything. Thank you for your help. Well, what's our next course of action?
We should go to Fair Devotion's house, since that's where Scootaloo and Turning Page are. Rainbow Dash has more than likely made it to them, knowing her.
Then we should do just that. Let's go, everyone.
Wait a moment. What is it, Rarity?
I'm going to stay here.
Hmm?
I want to stay, so that I'll be able to see Sweetie Belle as soon as she gets out.
But don't you need an attorney to even be able to set foot in here?
Well, yes, but...
You guys get going. I'll stay here with Rarity.
You will, Polly? Really?
I said so, didn't I? What's the matter?
I think she's just surprised that you're being so casual about hanging around anywhere but the castle, I guess.
Hey, come on. I don't hate everything about this world, you know? And besides, I'd like to help out Rarity, even if it's just a bit of legal advice. I'll do what I can.
I truly do appreciate it, darling. And this has absolutely nothing to do with the fact that she's letting you use her hair products while we're here. Not at all.
It's not like that. Like I said, I don't hate everything here. Rarity, for instance. She's... what's the word? Refined. She takes herself seriously. I can appreciate that.
My, my. You certainly are a charming young man, aren't you?
Right.
All right. Sounds good, Apollo. We'll meet up with you later at the Everfree Forest, then.
Right. Good luck, you guys. I'll see you there.
That's odd. Why was the door left unlocked? Do you think Miss Devotion forgot about it?
I'm not sure. Maybe Rainbow Dash forgot to lock it after she arrived. Though I don't see her around.
Oh, Princess Twilight, Miss Cykes. I suppose I should have expected you. Though not all of you.
She seems out of it. Not quite tired. Melancholy? I guess with everything that's happened, I would be too.
Good afternoon, Miss Devotion. Sorry to barge in unannounced like this.
It's all right, Princess Twilight. But what are you doing here? The trial's over.
It is, yes. But we wanted to stop by and check on Scootaloo and Turning Page. You know, see how they're doing?
I see. That's rather considerate of you, Miss Cykes.
So, may we see them?
I suppose so. Follow me. They're right over here.
Oh, hey! You guys made it! How was, the detention center?
Not a great deal of help, really. Sweetie Belle's being questioned and probably will be for a little while.
That blows. And, what about Rarity?
She decided to stay there along with Apollo for when Sweetie Belle is released.
Right, right.
How are you doing, Scootaloo?
Scoots is doing just fine. Isn't that right, Squirt?
Let Scootaloo speak, Rainbow.
Right, yeah. Sorry.
I'm okay, I guess. I'm just really tired.
Tired?
Yeah, I mean, before I was super excited and happy, but now that the trial's over, it all just kind of hit me at once. How intense it was, I mean.
All you need is a little rest, that's all. Then you'll be up and at 'em in no time.
I just hope Turning's okay.
Miss Cykes, Princess Twilight, every pony, what are you doing here?
Hi, Turning Page. We wanted to check up on you and Scootaloo. How are you holding up?
I guess I'm okay. I'm relieved the trial's over, that's for sure.
As am I. And I suppose I have you three to thank.
Huh? Us three? But it was only Twilight and me.
Yes, and I am grateful for your efforts in defending Turning Page and Scootaloo. But I must also thank Princess Luna.
Why would you thank her? She tried to pin the blackmailing on you! Aren't you the least bit mad about that?
On the contrary, I was well aware that Princess Luna planned to accuse me from the very beginning.
What? You were?
Yes, Princess Luna actually proposed the idea to me before the trial began.
And you went along with it? Knowing that you could have been charged for a crime you didn't even commit?
Of course, Princess Twilight. How could I refuse? The lives of my son and his friend were on the line. I would have done anything to prove their innocence. Anything. Besides, it worked out in the end, as I hoped it would. Thanks to Princess Luna accusing me, you two were able to expose the truth and get Turning and Scootaloo's acquittal.
Talk about self-sacrifice. Maybe this is where Turning gets that from now that I think about it.
Hang on a second. Does that mean Luna was aware that the magazines might have been planted in your house?
The possibility had crossed her mind, yes, but she had no way of proving it. She decided, instead, to work with how the evidence was discovered, and hoped that the defense would be able to provide an alternative theory.
Which led to us learning that Diamond Tiara had planted the magazines here.
Exactly.
All this intricacy. It's almost as if Luna knows everything about the case. It makes me wonder why she even bothered prosecuting Turning and Scootaloo in the first place.
Well, not everything, remember? She didn't know about the clone until we were able to prove it existed. And she didn't know who the blood behind the statue belonged to either.
Not until Sonata and Private Eye revealed it to her after the trial, in any case.
But even so, if she was so dead set on proving Scootaloo and Turning Page innocent, why didn't she at least let us in on the plan? She told Miss Devotion, she told Scootaloo and Turning. Heck, Sakura and Private Eye may have been in on it as well. Everyone seemed to know what was going to happen during the trial, except for us. Doesn't that seem a bit counterproductive?
You do have a point. She even went to great lengths to ensure that we didn't know she was the prosecutor. Her actions do seem rather contradictory in that regard.
Princess Luna, what drove you to be so secretive towards us? We're all on the same side here, aren't we?
That reminds me. Has Princess Luna expressed any knowledge about whoever sent that anonymous tip?
Not that I know of. And we don't have a clear idea of who might have sent it either.
That is unfortunate.
Why do you ask?
No reason, really. Just... If it hadn't been for that tip, Turning Page wouldn't have been involved, and Princess Luna wouldn't have had to resort to accusing me.
We do plan on asking Private Eye later to see if he knows anything about it.
Then I do hope you are able to discover its sender.
Athena? Twilight?
Yes, Scootaloo?
I'm really worried about Sweetie Belle. You said that you weren't able to talk to her at the detention center?
No, we weren't. But as we said, Rarity's there, along with Apollo, so she won't be alone. Don't worry.
Well, if you are able to talk to her later, are you going to ask if she'd let you defend her?
Rarity already gave us permission, but we do plan on offering Sweetie Belle directly. Yes.
That's good to hear.
What's wrong, Scootaloo?
I don't know. It's just this case, royal order, Sweetie Belle, everything. I'm just scared, I think. I don't know what's going to happen next. And what I did to royal order, well, one of them, anyway, how I accidentally stabbed him with my scooter. And how Sweetie Belle, she might have done something similar. Something that she doesn't even fully remember.
Having to recall something unpleasant you did is, admittedly, never a great feeling. But it's through these recollections that the truth is eventually uncovered, Scootaloo. Just like with you today. And no matter what might have happened, it's better to be aware of it than live in ignorance. I can't say for certain what Sweetie Belle did or didn't do with the statue that night, but whatever it was, we'll find out. I'm sure it'll show us that she didn't kill anyone.
That's right! Chin up, kid. I'm sure Sweetie Belle will be just fine. Athena and Twilight will clear her name, just like they did with you and Turning Page.
Really? That's not what you said earlier at the castle.
Well, you know, it's just what Applebloom said.
Rainbow Dash? What's Twilight talking about? What did you say earlier?
It's, well, look. Sweetie Belle wasn't exactly being all that helpful when you were arrested, remember? I'm still a little miffed about that.
You can't sweep that all under the rug, Rainbow. Sometime soon, you'll have to come clean about what you're really feeling. Not just for Scootaloo's sake, but yours as well.
Oh, I understand. I guess I'm still bothered by that, too. But it doesn't make me any less worried, though.
We'll do our best, Scootaloo. You have my word.
Thank you, Athena.
So what Turning said is true.
What do you mean, Miss Devotion?
When I came to pick him and Scootaloo up, he told me that Sweetie Belle was arrested.
Yeah, it was proven that she was in the forest that night. But she wasn't involved in Royal Order's death! It's just a coincidence! Or something!
Could that be it, I wonder?
What did she just say?
Miss Devotion, I know this is a difficult time for you, but would it be at all possible for us to ask you a few questions about your husband? It might help us clear Sweetie Belle's name.
I suppose so. What would you like to know?
We learned during the trial that, for the past month, Royal Order's been away in Canderlot. He was apparently even offered vacations, but turned them down. Any idea why he's been away for so long?
It's more of a recent development, if I'm being honest. My husband's job has kept him busier than usual lately.
He used to come home to us whenever he had the chance. He looked forward to it, he told me.
Did he ever talk to you about it, or say anything about why you'd been spending so much time away?
Well...
No, not really. He kept his reasons to himself.
Yeah.
There's no doubt about it. She's hiding something. Turning seems like he may know the reason, but as long as Fair's here, we're not going to get it out of him.
Because he spent so much time away, Canterlot had almost become like a second home to him. He had a travel case prepared for every time he had to go.
A travel case?
Is there any chance we could see it?
I'm afraid not. It was seized by the police yesterday. According to that gentle colt investigator, it was important evidence.
You mean Private Eye?
Yes, I believe that was his name. You'll have to ask him about it.
We'll make sure to do that.
That was weird. Miss Devotion acted like she couldn't remember his name. but I didn't detect any hint of sudden recognition when Twilight mentioned it.
Hey, Daddy!
Yeah, Trucy?
You know what today's date is.
The date? Well, it's February 14th. Bye.
Of all the places for Mr. Wright to start, it's not gonna be here, Trucy.
I know what you're thinking, Athena, but it's not about that. I just noticed something, and wanted to know if I was right.
Sorry. What was it you noticed?
This calendar hanging on the wall. See? There's a date circled in red here. Today's date. Did you plan on doing something with your husband today, Miss Devotion?
I mean, it is Valentine's Day, after all.
You mean Hearts and Hooves Day?
Hearts and Hooves Day?
Yes. It's a holiday where you give special attention to ponies you appreciate, or your special sunpony.
Special sunpony?
It's basically a term that you'd use to refer to sunpony you're dating, or in a relationship with. On Hearts and Hooves Day, you'd see a lot of couples giving gifts to their partners.
So, it's exactly like Valentine's Day.
In regards to your question, yes, I did have plans for today. Royal and I were going to go to a fancy restaurant for dinner, but I had to cancel it after that whole incident with Spoiled Rich.
Was that why no one was home when I came to get turning to a night ago?
Yes, I was out at the time, canceling my dinner reservations. I had hoped to reschedule it for a later date, but obviously, that doesn't matter anymore.
How dare that mare demand anything from us! After what her daughter did, I oughta—
Turning page. That is quite enough of your outbursts.
But, Mom, surely you can see that it wasn't right.
Yes, and it also wasn't right to attack those fillies, either. Need I remind you of what it led to?
You're right. It is kind of my fault, isn't it? I mean, you had to cancel your dinner plans, and then Father—
I'm so sorry, Miss Devotion. I didn't mean to drag up sad memories.
It's all right. We'll manage. We'll find a way. We always have.
But what about Miss Stamp? I feel bad about that, too.
Huh? Why's that?
Turning?
Well, because she and my mom were childhood friends. She's probably the closest pony to her.
Really? Is that true, Miss Devotion?
Yes, it is. We were close.
Huh? Seriously? She's hesitant to even say that. What gives?
In any case, I think we should let these kids rest. They've had a long day. Thank you for coming to check up on us, but I do think you had better get going. I wouldn't want to impede your investigation any further. Rainbow Dash, why don't you take Scootaloo home?
Sure, yeah, that sounds like a good idea. We'll actually head back to the castle. If you guys need us, that's where we'll be. You ready, Squirt?
Just one more thing. Twilight? Athena?
Yes, Scootaloo? What is it?
Just, please, regardless of how hurt I feel, please find a way to help Sweetie Belle.
We'll try, Scootaloo. Until the very end.
Well, that was abrupt.
And we aren't much closer to the truth either. By the way, did anyone else get the feeling that Miss Devotion's hiding something?
No, she is. Definitely. But what could it be? And why?
If it could help us figure out what really happened to Royal Order, I don't know why she would keep it to herself. Unless...
Are you thinking that she might be involved in his death?
I don't know. She might just be trying to protect someone.
Whatever the case, I don't think Fair Devotion's about to tell us what she knows. At least... not at the moment.
I guess that's true. Where to next then, Twilight?
I think we'd better go and visit Diamond Tiara's house. I can't say I'm really looking forward to that.
Me neither. But yeah, let's get going. Nice to see you, too. Your dad, Mr. Rich, let us in, actually. We were hoping to—
Miss Cykes? Princess Twilight! And I guess these must be your friends?
Yes, this is Phoenix Wright and his daughter, Trucy.
More humans?
Oh, boy.
Hiya, I'm Trucy. You're Silver Spoon and Diamond Tiara, right? It's really nice to meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you too, Trucy. Did you come here to gloat? Rub your victory in our faces? Well, we aren't going to give you the satisfaction.
Come on, DT. I doubt they're the types to do that. Princess Twilight definitely wouldn't.
Fine.
Actually, we're just here to ask a few questions, if you don't mind.
Well, I don't really have a choice here. Daddy will probably make my punishment even worse if I don't cooperate. What about you, Sylvie?
It'd be our pleasure. What do you want to know?
Huh. What do you know? He may have bailed his daughter out, but Mr. Rich still seems intent on disciplining his child. Guess he's not the rich snob I imagined he'd be. Well, I think it'd be best if we start with your testimonies. Are you?
What? Oh, come on! We already had to testify in court! We have to do it again?
That's not what I meant, Diamond Tiara. I just wanted to clarify a few things about it, really. And besides, I'd rather eat nails than slog through any more testimonies from you both.
Well, alright. But there really isn't that much to talk about.
Nevertheless, I'd like to ask anyway. First of all, was there anything wrong in what we discovered during the trial as to the events of the night of the murder?
No! It's exactly as we said. We arrived in the forest around 9:15 and got to the ruins at 9:50, 10 minutes before we said the blackmail negotiations were going to happen.
And you already know the rest. Scootaloo and Turning Page showed up, we got into a fight, and that cult threw my tiara in the gorge!
And after we got the tiara back, that was when we saw Royal Order's body. And also we saw Zecora coming our way. After that, we ran off, not wanting to get caught.
Right. That still matches with everything they said during the trial.
Is it true, though? That there were two Royal Orders? And that one of them was a clone?
That's what it certainly seems, yes. Why?
It's just that cult. He must be very upset right now.
He is. But he's putting on a brave face, for himself and his mother.
Well, that was a surprise. I honestly didn't expect Silver Spoon to care about Turning Page. And you never saw any pony else while you were running away?
Nope. No one.
I don't think so. But then again, my glasses were broken, so it's not like I could have seen a whole lot.
That must mean neither of them saw Sweetie Belle in the forest.
Why are you asking us all this anyway? Don't you already know everything that happened that night?
We have a good idea of most of the events, yeah?
Then why are you bothering asking us again?
It's because we need your help. You see, Sweetie Belle's been arrested on suspicion of being involved with those very same events.
What? She has? But why?
Her blood was found mixed with the blood found at the Nightmare Moon statue. That proves that she was there that night, but we have no idea what she has to do with Royal Order's death.
But we're doing everything we can to try and save her. We know she couldn't have anything to do with it. And that's why we're asking you these questions now, Diamond Tiara. But you two really don't remember anything else about that night? Anything beyond what you've already told the court?
No! You already know everything that happened. There's nothing else we can say.
Yeah, I really wish we could tell you something more to help Sweetie Belle, but...
It's all right. Thank you for cooperating at any rate.
If only my stupid glasses hadn't broke! Then maybe I would have seen something!
Actually, Silver Spoon, just how powerful are your glasses?
They're definitely pretty powerful. I'm nearsighted and my vision is sometimes close to 2200.
2200? That's crazy! You'd basically be unable to see anything more than a few feet ahead of you!
Yeah, I'm pretty much blind without my glasses. That's why it was really important I got a new pair as soon as the first one broke.
Right. And Princess Luna said you had an appointment the day after. What time did you go?
It was around 4:30. It went on for about half an hour. Why do you ask?
No real reason, I guess. I just wanted to confirm what Princess Luna said during the trial.
I still wish we didn't have to testify. If only my glasses hadn't broken that night. Heck, if only I didn't have to wear glasses.
You don't like to wear them?
Not really. I mean, I know they're necessary to let me see, but they're just so bulky and annoying. Sometimes I think I look like an old mare wearing them. I think Granny Smith might have a similar pair.
Don't worry, Sylvie. Yours are way more stylish than the old buddies.
Maybe so. But I just wish I didn't have to wear them, even though I have to, you know?
Well,
not you. You, obviously, Miss Cykes, since you don't wear glasses.
Actually, I was going to say I think I get what you're going through.
Huh? You do?
Yes, well, it's true I don't wear glasses. When I was a kid, I had to wear these special headphones all the time because my hearing was so strong I couldn't live properly. I hated wearing them. They were heavy and uncomfortable, and everyone stared at me because I always had them on. They honestly made me feel like a freak.
That's horrible. Who would make you wear something like that?
My mother.
Your mother?
Yes, she was a scientist, and as part of her research, she designed those headphones before she was, passed away. I thought they were actually amplifying my hearing and that my mother was using me to further her research. Like I was an experiment to her or something. It made me start to hate her for making me wear them. It wasn't until years later that I realized they were actually designed to dampen my hearing. She was just trying to watch out for me in the end.
It sounds like she really did care for you.
Yeah, she did. I wish I had known that before.
I wish my parents were like that.
Oh, Sylvie.
Silver Spoon, what do you mean by that?
It's just, sometimes it doesn't feel like they're really around. Like, when I went to get my glasses, Mom and Dad only stuck around long enough to be there for when I got them. Afterwards, they had to leave to go to work. They didn't even ask how I felt about the new pair. I know I shouldn't feel mad about that, since them working meant we could afford those glasses, but I don't know. I just wish they didn't have to go away all the time. Doing their jobs, keeping ponies healthy. Good. I know what they do is good. I'm just so sick and tired of being left behind. It makes me feel like I'm being forgotten. Like I'm alone. They only ever want to spend time with me when they want to see what new medical skills I've learned. Otherwise, they don't really pay me any mind. It's why I'm even at DT's house right now. They left as soon as they brought me home. I wanted someone to talk to.
Silver Spoon. Her heart. I had a feeling she was lonely, but it's like her heart is tearing itself apart. It's crying out, desperate to be heard. Silver Spoon, I...
Don't be silly, Sylvie!
Huh? DT?
Diamond?
Look, I get it. Your parents aren't the greatest, sure, but that doesn't mean you're alone. I mean, you have me! And no matter how much you might look like a bit of an old granny, that is never going to change.
Do you really mean that?
Of course! You're my best friend, Silver Spoon!
And you're my best friend, Diamond Tiara!
Loneliness is a terrible thing. I should know. And from what I've seen of this world so far, there are a lot of ponies who are suffering from it. Coco, overall concept, and now Fair Devotion and Silver Spoon. But with these two, even though all they have really is each other, something tells me that will be enough. Sometimes, just one friend is all it takes. Funny, we came here to get a better understanding of the case, but I think we got a better understanding of these two fillies instead.
Well, I think that's all the questions we have. Thanks for answering them, girls.
Of course, Princess Twilight. We're sorry we couldn't tell you anything else, but you'll help out Sweetie Belle, right? There's been enough trouble already. I don't want any pony else getting hurt.
We will. We'll find the truth, one way or another, and save Sweetie Belle.
Then, good luck, Miss Cykes. And thanks for listening to me.
You're very welcome, Silver Spoon.
You girls take care, okay?
Of course we will.
Hold on a moment, you three. I think you should see this.
See what, Daddy?
While Twilight and Athena were busy talking to the girls, I noticed something in Diamond Tiara's trash.
I thought you were pretty quiet for a minute there.
You make it sound like I'm some sort of chatterbox.
Why were you rooting around in Diamond Tiara's trash can?
Just a hunch I had. I managed to take a quick picture of what it was before we left. Look.
Another magazine?
Wait, is it the same one from which the blackmail letter got its clippings?
I can't really tell. I had to snap it quickly before they noticed. It definitely looks like one of those gossip magazines about you girls. If I didn't have to sneak the shot, I might have gotten a better angle, or a peek at what was in it.
With that brick, you're lucky you can take pictures at all, boss.
In any case, I don't think this is a coincidence. We'll definitely have to look into this more.
Agreed. But for now, we should move on. What should we do next, Athena?
I think we have to find Zecora and question her. We should also probably investigate all the new scenes the trial uncovered. So, I guess it's back to the Everfree Forest.
Come on, let me in! I'm a lawyer, too!
Sorry, Mr. Justice, but no one can enter the forest at the moment.
What? That's ridiculous!
Hey, Apollo.
Oh, hey! You guys made it.
Have you been waiting long?
No, I just got here. But these guards won't let me pass. I even showed them that silly badge and everything.
Well, at least that gives us a chance to catch up. How are things back at the detention center?
Less productive than I would have liked. I did my best to calm Rarity and Sweetie Belle down, but I didn't get much more information out of the latter. She seemed really shaken up by everything, so I didn't want to push it.
I can't imagine. Still, that's unfortunate. I was hoping we would find something that could point us in the right direction.
I take it that the investigation hasn't been very fruitful on your end, either?
Not really, no. We learned a bit more about Royal Order from Fair Devotion, but not much else. Seems like both sides aren't being very forthcoming, for one reason or another. This investigation is looking like it's reaching a dead end.
Maybe not, Athena. I might not have gotten any new info directly, but I did notice one thing.
You did?
Yeah. Sweetie Belle's got a tell. Did you notice it?
No, I can't say I did. That's kind of your department, buddy.
Oh, I think I might have. Back in the defendant lobby. Is it when she rubs her right foreleg?
Right on the money, Trucy.
Oh yeah, now that you mention it, she did do that an awful lot, didn't she? Both at Carousel Boutique? And back at court. Do you think that means she's hiding something?
She definitely is. But it was difficult to say what exactly, or what triggered that tell in the first place. And with how frantic she was, it didn't feel right to push her on it.
At the very least, that gives us something we can ask her about, once we're able to.
Excuse me, Miss Guard's Pony?
Yes, Princess Twilight?
Now that we're all here, is there any chance we can actually enter the forest?
I'm sorry, Your Highness, but we can't allow any pony in, even you.
What? Why not?
We're under strict orders not to let any pony in until the lead investigator, Private Eye, returns.
You mean he's still in Canterlot? How long is he going to be there?
We don't know, but until he does return, our orders are to remain here and prevent any pony from entering. That includes you, Princess Twilight.
I see. Thank you for letting us know.
Well, that certainly throws a wrench into our plans. What now?
Maybe Apollo could be bait for one of the guards. He could distract them or pull them away for a bit.
Why am I not surprised that I'm the bait?
It makes sense! I mean, with your hair, you could look kind of like a weird bipedal unicorn monster. That would definitely get one of the guards' attention.
Yeah, and it wouldn't be the first time you've been mistaken for a monster. Remember Jinxie Tenma?
Maybe that wasn't the best question. Anyway, what exactly would I do as bait? Make a scene and just hope they don't pay attention to the other three humans just hanging around here?
Yeah, that way I can suplex the other one. With both of them out of commission, we'd be able to sneak past easy peasy.
Athena?
Is that your answer to everything?
I was joking, Apollo. Jeez. Learn to lighten up, would you? Regardless, we have to do something. Private Eye isn't here, and we can't exactly stand around waiting for him. We need his help.
Well, it looks like I'll be helping you out for a second time today.
Sonata?
Princess Twilight, Mr. Wright, it's good to see you both again.
It is? It is. Great to see you too, Sonata. How are you?
Real smooth, boss.
So you're the Sonata that Mr. Wright was talking about yesterday. I gotta say, it's nice to meet you in person. In pony?
It's nice to meet you as well. Although I don't believe we've all been formally introduced.
Right. I'm Apollo Justice. I'm a defense attorney that works at Mr. Wright's office.
And I'm Trucy. Trucy Wright.
Oh, he's your father. Mr. Wright, I wasn't aware you had a daughter.
Well, it's a long story.
One of many, I imagine. You do look a little older after all.
That's true, sadly. On both accounts.
Perhaps you'll tell them to me sometime. And you are Ms. Athena Cykes, correct? I remember you from the trial.
Yes, that's me. You can just call me Athena, though. Oh, thank goodness she doesn't remember me as Golden Pixie. Actually, I feel like I should thank you for your help, Sonata. If you and Private Eye hadn't shown up when you did, we would have had to extend that trial even further.
There's no need to thank me, Athena. I was just doing my duty. Besides, you really managed to put up a spirited defense, despite all the setbacks against you.
You think so? I can't say I really agree. I still feel terrible about what I did.
You're referring, of course, to accusing Zecora.
Yeah.
You've already settled the issue with her, haven't you? Furthermore, your clients, Turning Page and Scootaloo, were proven innocent. I'm certainly not saying you shouldn't feel guilty for what you did, but perhaps you don't need to put yourself down for it all the time.
I guess. But I also feel bad about how all of that resulted in Sweetie Belle getting arrested.
Ah, I see. I know we just met, Athena, so you may take what I say with a grain of salt. But you can't blame yourself for everything that happened. It won't help you or your client, and it certainly won't help you find the truth. I should know.
Hey, wait. How do you know Sweetie Belle's gonna be our client?
Well, why else would you be out here, trying to get into the Everfree Forest?
I see.
This intense guilt that you're feeling, Athena, it doesn't quite suit someone with as much perseverance as yourself.
wouldn't you say? And besides, you're not the only person who can be blamed. After all, the test that Private Eye and I ran revealed the owner of the second bloodstain.
But you couldn't have known—
True. And neither could you, wouldn't you say? Is something the matter, Princess Twilight?
No, it's just... you've changed, Sonata.
Is that so? You sound surprised. Jail does have a tendency to change ponies.
That reminds me. Sonata, we've heard a lot about you from Daddy and Twilight, but I don't think either of them ever told us why you were in jail.
Tracy, you can't just ask people that.
To be honest, Mr. Wright, I'm also kind of curious.
Me too. I want to hear all about this attorney who just saved our butts.
It's fine, Mr. Wright. I've made my peace with who I was and what I did. And I find that talking about it makes it easier to accept and move on. Yes, you're correct that I am an attorney, Athena. But that wasn't always the case. My name is Sonata, and I was a criminal. Specifically a blackmailer. I dealt in ponies' secrets, in procuring and using them against their owners, in order to come out on top. It never bothered me. At least I thought it didn't. But that changed after an incident involving a race known as the Equestrian 500. I had partnered with one of the athletes, Ace Swift. We'd worked together for a while, successfully blackmailing several athletes in previous races. The racers would be forced to drop out or hand the win over to Ace if they didn't want their secrets to be leaked. It was a very successful enterprise. Ace was a celebrity, and I was his successful manager. No pony had any idea of what we were doing. It worked for a time, until we tried to blackmail Rainbow Dash. What should have been a simple case of leverage turned into a terrible nightmare.
A terrible nightmare?
Yes. Rainbow refused to meet our demands and flew off before Ace could stop her. Ace was furious, but by that point, I had already wanted to stop blackmailing ponies. The guilt of what we had been doing eventually caught up with me. Once Rainbow flew off, I told him how I felt, and he completely snapped. I figured he'd panic, since he thought he'd be ruined without my help. What I didn't expect was just how far he'd go to try and hide his crimes.
What do you mean?
In his rage, he tried to kill me. So, I defended myself. By the end of it all, Ace was dead. And I was left with a crime to cover up. I was scared. I didn't just fear that my blackmailing would be found out, but also that I would be blamed for Ace's death. And so I had the sudden idea to pin the whole thing on Rainbow Dash.
And that led Twilight to summoning Daddy to defend her, right?
Exactly. And though the path to get there was rough, eventually I managed to prove Rainbow's innocence.
That's not all you proved, though, Mr. Wright.
You mean there's more?
I pinned the death on Rainbow because I thought I had actually murdered Ace. But as Mr. Wright managed to prove, there never was a murder. Ace's death was really a freak accident, a death caused by the elements of nature itself. I still had to serve a sentence, of course. There was never any doubt about that. But afterwards, I reaffirmed my decision to stop going down that path and start doing for others what they'd done for me. Help those in need. Find the truth in any way I could.
You inspire everyone you come across, don't you?
I think you might be giving me a little too much credit here.
Is this why you wanted to represent Scootaloo?
Part of it was why, yes. It was a bit shocking when she turned me down. But when she said she wanted that human attorney to take her case, it suddenly all made sense. Of course, that attorney ended up being you, Athena. I don't think I could have done a finer job at defending her myself.
Wow. And to think this pony used to be a blackmailer. Boss must have made a heck of an impression on her.
At any rate, it really is good that you're here, Sonata. Any chance you can help us get into the forest to continue our investigation?
Unfortunately, no. Their orders are very strict. But I do have some good news for you all. Private Eye just arrived back from Canterlot.
He has? Where can we find him?
Right now, he's at the detention center with Sugar Stamp. I was actually on my way there now.
Great! Mind if we tag along? That way we can talk to him and find out more about Miss Stamp.
I suppose I wouldn't mind the company.
Back here again, and still as gloomy as ever.
Let's find Private Eye quickly, then. I don't want to be here any longer than we need to.
Ah, I didn't expect you to come here so quickly. Good afternoon to you all.
Good afternoon, Detective. Do you know if Sweetie Belle or Sugar Stamp are out of questioning?
I'm afraid Miss Sweetie Belle is being questioned once again. But Miss Sugar Stamp hasn't started yet. I assume you want to talk to her?
That's their plan, yes.
Oh, Miss Sonata. I wasn't aware you had tagged along.
It was a bit of a chance meeting. We met just outside of the Everfree Forest.
That's actually what we wanted to talk to you about, too, before we questioned Miss Sugarstamp.
Is that so?
Yes. Why exactly have you had the forest blocked off?
Ah, right. My reasoning is quite simple. With all of the new information that Sonata and I discovered, we couldn't risk anypony else tampering with it. Hence why I've had it cordoned off, for the time being.
Well, we'll need access to the crime scene eventually. Could you give us permission to investigate?
Certainly, Princess. Once we are finished here, I will inform the guards at the entrance to let you all pass. In fact, I'd meant to do that just as I arrived from Canterlot, but my duties here kept me from heading off immediately.
That actually leads me to another question. What were you doing in Canterlot? I would have thought you'd stick around Ponyville to continue your investigation.
Right. Well, the truth is, Miss Cykes, I was summoned to Canterlot.
Summoned? By who?
Lawkeeper Equity.
Lawkeeper Equity? You mean the pony who heads the High Council?
The very same. She wanted an update as to the current investigation's progress.
Wait, how come she was interested in a murder in Ponyville of all places?
It was due to the fact that the victim was a member of the Royal Guard, you see. You must understand. The High Council represents, in many ways, the public during times of national duress. Given the nature of this crime, and to whom it was committed, it is only logical that they, and therefore Lawkeeper Equity, should want to stay up to date regarding any and all developments.
I see. So about Miss Stamp's arrest, was there anything new you were able to uncover about her connection to the crime?
We were, Your Highness. A search of her home revealed some rather incriminating evidence.
What? Incriminating evidence? What do you mean?
I mean that it's evidence that connects Miss Sugarstamp to Royal Order's death.
Can we see this evidence, Detective?
Unfortunately, Princess Twilight, that evidence is no longer in my possession. I handed it over to the local authorities for analysis. Until they are through, no one can access it. Moreover, if anyone were to access it, I'm not sure it would be helpful.
Why do you say that?
Because Miss Sugarstamp has already confessed to killing Royal Order.
She what?
But why? Why on earth would she do that?
I haven't the foggiest idea, miss. She confessed virtually as soon as we apprehended her, after all.
Hang on. Did she confess to both Royal Order's deaths?
Good catch, Miss Cykes. The answer is no. She merely confessed to killing one, the one in the forest clearing. However, we could not ascertain for what reason she'd do it.
There's no sense in speculating. We'll need to hear what she has to say about it.
That would indeed appear to be the best course of action.
Well, should we speak with her now?
We definitely have to. But I wouldn't even know where to begin. This was an absolute bombshell to drop on us.
Wait, before we do that, There are some other things I'd like to ask you, Private Eye. Is that okay?
Of course, Mr. Wright. What is it?
The first is about the anonymous tip that led to Turning Page being arrested. His mother, Miss Fair Devotion, wanted to know if you had figured out who had sent it.
I see. Well, I'm sorry to say that the tip is still undergoing examination. I'm afraid I'll have to get back to you on that.
I guess that's to be expected.
What else did you want to ask?
We learned something else from Fair Devotion when we went to speak with her earlier. She told us that whenever he went on assignments to Canterlot, Royal Order would take a special travel case with him.
Ah, yes. Miss Devotion did inform us of its existence.
Does that mean you have that case?
You've come at a rather inopportune time, I'm afraid. That case is much like the anonymous tip, undergoing examination. It won't be ready for viewing for quite some time.
Ugh.
But rest assured, once we are finished, I will have them ready for your perusal the next time we meet. I can promise you that.
All right. Thanks anyway, Detective.
Was there anything else you needed me for?
No, I think that was everything.
In which case, I had better take my leave. As I said before, I will make my way to the Everfree Forest entrance to allow you to enter unhindered. With any luck, by the time you've finished your questioning, I'll still be there, hopefully with both the anonymous tip and the travel case.
We'll see you then. Goodbye, Private Eye.
Farewell, and good luck.
I guess we'd better go see Sugar Stamp then.
I guess so. But honestly, now I'm a little concerned. Who knows what she's going to say?
Sugar Stamp?
Why, hello, everypony! It's great to see you all!
Are you okay, Miss Stamp?
Oh, I'm sorry, little miss. I don't have any candies with me, so you'll have to wait for them another time.
We aren't here for candies, Miss Stamp.
Really? Well, that's all right. It's still nice of you all to come and visit little old me.
Actually, Miss Stamp, I'm afraid this is far from a courtesy call.
Yes, we have a few questions for you, if you don't mind.
Of course I don't mind! I am at your service, ma'am! What do you want to ask me?
We want to know about you confessing to murdering Royal Order.
Oh, of course. What about it?
So it's true? You really did confess to murdering Royal Order?
But why? Why would you do that?
You mean confess?
Yes!
Isn't it obvious? Ponies confess when they know they did something wrong.
So it's true. You really did kill him.
I wouldn't have confessed if otherwise.
No! I refuse to believe that! You couldn't have! You just couldn't have!
Trucy?
Sorry, Daddy.
I have to agree with Trucy on this, though. I find it hard to believe you, of all ponies, would want to kill Royal Order. I mean, why would you want to? What motive could you possibly have?
It doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter? How can you say that?
Because she confessed. And as far as the investigation is concerned, that wraps up that particular loose end. With her confession and silence on the matter, the case is closed. As much as I dislike having to admit it.
It's okay, everypony. You can go now. Have a nice day!
No. I know it's far from closed. She's hiding something. Her true motive, maybe. Or something else. But this is anything but an open and shut case. Unfortunately, I don't see a way of getting her to open up about why she killed him, but maybe if I talk about some other ponies involved. It may interest you, Sugar Stamp, to learn that before we came here, we went and visited Fair Devotion at her house. Turning Page and Scootily were there.
They were? Oh, how are they? I didn't get a chance to check on them during the trial.
They're fine, But they're certainly concerned about you. Neither of them can really believe you had anything to do with the crime.
Well, kids believe what they want to believe.
And I guess that extends to fair devotion as well.
Diva?
Huh? Diva?
Oh, that's just what I call fair devotion from time to time.
A nickname, huh? Let me guess. That's something you started calling her a long time ago, right? When you were kids?
How did it?
It's the same with me. A friend and I have had nicknames for each other since childhood. We're really close, actually. Is it the same with you and Fair Devotion?
Oh, yes, very! We've been friends since we were both fillies! We grew up in the same town, moved in the same circles, did each other's hair, talked about all the cute stallions that we saw, like Royal Order for one.
Huh? You mean you knew Royal Order before he met Fair Devotion?
Yep. In fact, I was the one who introduced Diva to him. The way he looked at her and the way she looked at him. Well, I don't want to sound mushy, but sometimes you just know when two ponies will make a great couple. And it's kind of funny, too, because Diva introduced me to my husband around the same time.
Wait, you're married? I didn't know that. Has your husband visited you yet?
Oh. Well, you see, my husband, he passed away about half a year ago from a heart attack.
I'm sorry, I didn't know.
It's okay, Miss Cykes. I don't really talk about it anyway. Sometimes ponies still call me Mrs. by mistake, though. Since we had the ceremony in Ponyville, after all.
I see.
It wasn't much, but I still think of it fondly. I thought that love would last forever! I was wrong. Admittedly, it was hard. Those first few days and weeks after. I thought everything would stop. But the clocks kept ticking, the pianos played, and the sun and moon rose. The world went on, but I felt that my world had ended. I wasn't sure what to do or how to move forward. That's why I was especially thankful that I had Royal Order and Fair Devotion to help me out.
What do you mean?
Well, Royal Order would often come up to Canterlot to keep me company. I didn't want to be alone with the memories. Having him there gave me the strength to keep going, I think. And Diva? Well, it couldn't have been easy. She was a mom with an adorable little son to take care of. But even though she was busy being a parent and a school teacher, she tried to make as many trips to Canterlot as she could. All just to see me. Those two took time out of their lives to come and check up on me, to make sure I was okay. And for that, I will always be grateful.
Ms. Stamp, I hope this doesn't sound intrusive, but did Royal Order keep these visits consistent? Up until his death?
Yes, he did. He was a good friend. They all were. They made me feel like, well, like I was part of a family after I had lost mine. A family I never had.
I see.
I'm not sure what Sonata meant by asking that, but I think she's thinking what I'm thinking. There's so much sadness in Miss Stamp's voice, and yet so much gratitude and love for this family. Given that, how can I possibly believe she'd ever kill Royal Order? And based on how everyone else looks, they feel the same. None of this adds up. Why would she confess to killing some pony who meant so much to her? Miss Stamp.
Hey! Get back here, you little brat!
Huh? What's going on?
Athena! Twilight! Help!
Apple Bloom, what are you doing here?
Something happened!
You get back here! You can't just barge into the detention center whenever you want!
Let me go!
Guard! Release Apple Bloom this instant!
Princess Twilight. It's crowded enough in here already. And besides, this kid just pushed past the guards into a restricted area, which is clearly a violation of—
I said, release her!
Yes, Princess.
Okay, Applebloom. Please calm down and tell us what happened.
It's about Rarity's home!
Carousel Boutique? What about it?
It's been broken into!
What?
Are you serious?
Come on, we have to get over there. If we move fast enough, we might be able to catch the perpetrator before they leave.
Guards, bring some backup. We'll need to surround the place with as many ponies as we can.
Run away, Princess.
With the news of the recent break-in, we all dashed out of the detention center, uncertain of what we would find. But more than that, we were even more uncertain of everything that we discovered so far. Sweetie Belle's arrest, Sugar Stamp's confession, Royal Order's motivations, Fair Devotion's silence, the two murders, the cloning, Luna, what she was trying to do. I had no idea where this case would take us, but I had the feeling it would continue to twist and turn as time went on, before we finally uncovered the truth.
Together we can see.